Happy Saturday, guys! And as you can see, things have all got bats up here in the studio. Chris is just hanging around here, getting ready to take you through another workout for today. Before we get started, we've got an announcement from Chris.
Yeah, so some of you might have tuned in today, or at some point in the week, or at some point in the past, and thought these workouts are way too tough for me. So we have a whole new beginner's bootcamp that's available to you any time, it lasts for 1 month. So that beginner's bootcamp will build you up slowly to get to the point where you can do these workouts. So strongly encourage that if you, as I said, tune in, maybe you happen to tune in on one of our big one Wednesdays and you went running for the hills because you thought literally you can't do that. So get involved with our beginner's bootcamp and that'll give you a month of conditioning to get you ready. So at any time, you can find that beginner's bootcamp on Strongly Together.
Amazing. Guys, let's get into today's workout. Another fun one. I know I say they're all fun, but I just really do think they are fun. But another fun one today. We're going to start with 2 rounds, very gentle warm up. We're going to start with the hip flow. So 10 reps of this hip flow. We're going to take you through 1 rep so you can see what it is. We start in a child's pose. So that's going to be pushing those hips back. The next one is going to be driving the hips forward, taking the feet apart into our frog's pose. Really opening up the hips in the front. Then we're going to go back, you're going to take yourself into a pigeon, okay? And as you breathe through, you're going to fold yourself down, stand back up again into the next pigeon. Good job. Now we're going to go both the knees on the floor, and we're going to go through the needle from this position here. So we're going to drive the hand through, trying to touch the shoulder on the floor, and through to the other side. So that's 1 rep, guys, and you're going to do 10 reps of that, building it into your breath. So follow that flow. Once you've done 10 of those, you're going to do 10 alternating Cossack squats. So that's going to be 1, 2, 3, good job. Now we're going to do 5 burpees. Good job. Yeah, we've seen the burpees a lot this week, so we all know exactly what we're doing. Just a quick update on this kind of warm-up, guys. What we've done is we've increased the range of motion of your hips for today, so you can use them, okay? The alternating Cossack squats, we do them often, but we do them for a reason. You really, if you are unable to get into that position, a little bit of practice over a long time will get you better at doing the Cossack squats and make you infinitely better at all other movements, okay? So, moving to the next section, we want to practice some speed skaters. Okay? We're going to set you up for the speed skater and you're going to set yourself up at home moving the exact same distance. Everything we want to do, we want to make it measurable. So Chris has got a meter space over here. I don't know if you can see it in the video, but there's a line over here and there's a line over here. And what we're going to have Chris do is jump from side to side on the line. Chris, you have to go bigger.
Anyways, well, I was tired, but that was good. Yeah.
Okay, so we're going to make Chris go a little bit bigger.
And we're going to have a line there, and we're going to have a line there.
And this is going to be what Chris would want to stick to in the workout. Good job.
There you go.
Okay, and now, same thing for you guys at home. Take some time in your setup. Make sure you've got something, a measurable marker that you can work off for this whole workout, okay? So, now that you've practiced some of these, we're going to look at the structure of this. We're going to do 5 rounds. You're going to do 17 speed skaters. Left and right equals 1. Then 17 push-ups. Then 17 double unders. And that's where the rope goes underneath the feet twice. So let's go over speed skaters we've done. Let's go over the push-up. I'll do some double unders after that. Good job. Okay, and then obviously you just go to the knees if you can't do the full push-up. Notice Chris's full body is straight, his shoulders drop down first, keeping that body in super alignment. Okay, your double under movement, guys. The rope passes underneath you twice. What you want to look for is having the elbows tucked into the body and the hands forward. And we're letting the wrist do the work, not the shoulders. Okay, so wrist to the work. Big one. If you're letting the wrist do the work, guys, everything else becomes a lot easier. If you can't do double unders, we'll do fast feet. Two.
Left, right, one. Left, right, two.
That's it. Okay, so 17 of each movement, 5 rounds, as fast as you can. Let us know how you get along, and we'll see you in the new week. Have a great Sunday.